Hey, this is Jennifer Bagley with CA Web Group, and you probably already watched the prior video, which is all about our premium engagement solution that ties into your website so that people can schedule appointments, they can contact you, send a message, make a payment, and so forth. So I promised that I would send out a video right after this that had a little bit of an overview on what the back office looks like, what you can do. So you're going to have a dashboard that looks like this. That you'll log into. Once you log in, then you're going to be in the back office of your scheduling system or your engagement system. So from here, you have your inbox. Inside your inbox, every time somebody submits an appointment request, it's going to show up with this red exclamation point. If somebody reschedules or they decline a meeting and so forth, then that's going to show up in your inbox. So same thing when appointments are completed. So today you'll see all of the different appointments that were had, completed, requested, and so forth. And this is my account. Now, each one of my team members also has their own account, and they can see their own requests. So it's not all jumbled together. Each individual person that or staff member on your team that has an account on the system, a user account on the system, gets to pretty much work within their own environment. They can see all their own appointments and calendar and date and schedules and so forth. And that way it's really, really easy to know. Once you log in here, everything in here applies to you. So first thing, you have the ability on the left-hand side to say new appointment, new message, new invoice, new client, or share document. You also can import and export customers right out of the system. So I'm going to move over to clients real quick. The system's simple. So if you don't have a CRM system, you know, a big powerhouse CRM, this is a great tool to have because this is essentially your CRM as far as everybody who has engaged with or interacted with your website. And this is how they're going to be able to keep track of their engagement with your website. So a lot of times CRMs are one-way places, right? It's where you can go and you can pull up your clients and you can see all of the engagements back and forth, but your clients don't have access to that. Prospects definitely don't have access to that. So if you're a CPA or you have a back office tool or project management system, then they may have some kind of interactivity back and forth. But if they're not a client yet and they don't have access to that, then it's very difficult to be able to track who they've talked to, when they talk to them, and so forth. So first things first, the CRM element of this is really, really simple. You can custom configure each one of these pieces of information. So don't get discouraged about seeing certain types of data tracked here because you can essentially track whatever you want. You can add and edit fields here. So as soon as you click on that, it gives you the ability to set your client card fields. When you set your client card fields, you can say, when is this field appropriate? So when somebody is scheduling, if there's somebody's contacting us, and is it a required field? You can set things as single line text field. This is your unique ID, which is essentially your email. You can also set things as drop down. So for me, I have to track certain referral partners, and I want to know where the business is coming from. I also have a lot of resellers that sell our services, and so I have to track if it's one of their deals as well. And it is that simple. So if you want to add a field, you just simply click on the field and, oops, pick one first. You want it to be a text area or a drop-down list. If it's text, you add it, boom, you say, when do you need it? So do you want somebody to fill it out when they're scheduling an appointment, when they're just contacting you, requesting more information, and is it required? You can drag and drop these fields around and move them wherever you'd like. So whatever is most important to you from a tracking standpoint. Once you're done, you hit save, or you can view a demo client or test drive a message. So when you check these out, it's going to show you this is what a demo card looks like, or this is what it looks like when somebody's trying to send you a message on your website. So pretty simple. Back to our dashboard. I'm going to go ahead and save changes, and we're going to slide back up to the main dashboard area. So the first thing we went into was clients. As I showed you, on the left-hand side, you have all of your customers who have had interaction with your website. So these are all ours. The nice part is if somebody is connected in Google or they've got a Gmail account, then the system's going to automatically pick up their social media links. It's going to add their social media profile picture and so forth, kind of like this. So you'll have links, email, and so forth. Now, from here, you can easily import new contacts. So if you have a CRM system or your QuickBooks account and you want your clients to already have an account in the system, then you can just simply add them in here. Again, don't get this, this is not your operational backend office when it comes to accounting or project management and so forth. This is just simply a tool that tracks and measures the activity that happens alongside your website or with your website. You can create a new client here. So import, export, CSV files and so forth, and you can edit your client pages. Now from here, let's go ahead and choose one of these, and I'm going to go down add edit fields because I want to show you some of the other setup configuration things. So first off, you're going to have your business info. You're able to upload your customized logo, your business name, a short description of who you are, what you do, language, as well as you can put in your contact information. If you're overseas or you have clients overseas, that's easy to be able to put in here, your address, main email accounts, password, and so forth. Then you can go down and add your staff. Now your team members, this is anybody on your team that scheduling is done with. So for example, I'm going to go ahead and click on my profile because all my stuff's public anyway. So right here, I'm going to put in a photo so people can quickly see who they're meeting with. I'm going to also put in my name, email, title, display name, and so forth. Now, I have the ability to choose from a service list. So I'm going to show you how to set up services and give you some ideas on different ways you can configure those. But for my account, what I'm saying is these are the services that I'll make myself available for. And if I'm going to accept one of these kind of appointments, this is my method of communicating. So for me, 99% of everything I do is either going to be on a webinar or it's a live event, like a speaking event or a webinar or something like that. So almost everything I do, though, is going to be a GoToMeeting, so you can put that in here, but you also have the ability to say it's going to be, that service is going to be held via phone call, in office, out of office, they're going to call you, you're going to call them, and so forth. So here's each of the services that I will make myself available for, and there's lots of ones that are not checked. Those are the things that I don't do. So I can quickly go over and I can say I want to test drive my appointment scheduling. These are all of the different services that are available. Some of them are for me, some of them are for other team members. All right, so back to, you can also set your schedule. So for different services, I have a different schedule set. My main schedule I have set from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. You can say if you want Saturdays, Sundays, and so forth. And you also have the ability to edit this schedule based on individual service that you offer or that you're making yourself available for. So if it's a free consultation or a presentation or an onboarding or training, or it's just simply somebody setting a time to talk to you about setting an appointment, like for a new patient or a new client or a service call or a maintenance call and so forth, any kind of service, it's definitely a lot easier to know and plan when those calls are going to take place than randomly answering phone calls. I'm pretty sure at some point you've had a conversation with yourself about how you manage your time when it comes to checking your email, right? If you go to project management or you go to time management courses, they're going to tell you to block time. You know, don't sit on email and check it throughout the day all day long. They're going to tell you the most effective people block time. They don't randomly bounce from topic to topic, task to task, to do. They're simply going to say, between this time and this time, this is my email management time. This time to this time, this is my appointment time. This time to this time, this is my strategy or execution or implementation or client services and so forth time. So if you're getting caught up saying, well, you know, everybody that wants a consultation, all they do is call in. And whoever is answering the phones, that's what they do. They answer it immediately. And there are going to be some people that are going to still do that process. However, if your customers are busy at work, then when they call in, or they may not want to call in, they want to set a time to be able to talk to you. So they know they're not going to get voicemail and so forth. So time blocking is one of the most important things you can do to have a more effective use of your time. All right, so in here, I'm gonna set my hours, what days I work, what time zone I'm in, and then I'm gonna go through and I'm going to configure this with my calendar. So for me, I use Google Calendar. There's a lot of other calendars you can choose from, but for our company, everybody's on Google Calendar because we wanna be able to see each other's appointments and schedules and so forth. And that's the easiest way to do this. So all I'm doing is I hit a button that says connect. It's tied into my Google Calendar. I choose the calendar. So this is all of our team's calendars that I want to see or that I want this to synchronize with. And that's how this knows what my busy times are, what my free times are. Next thing I'm going to do is set up my notifications. So for me, I want a text message anytime somebody sends me a new appointment, and I'll have the phone number that I'm going to send a text message to. 33. And then I'm going to say send a text message, and I'm going to save this. I also can set up my own signature. And my signature, it can say from you, or it can say from your scheduling team. It can have links and so forth in it. So pretty simple. I'm going to save this. And from here, I'm going to go back up to my inbox. So inside my inbox, now that my appointments are set, I'm going to be able to have people schedule. But let's go through and let's look at services. So we looked at staff. Essentially, your staff members are going to need to do the exact same thing. So they would, and I'll show you one that's not set up yet. So for this, they put in first, last, their information. They would go through and they would choose the type of services that they make themselves available for. So this one happens to be our video production. So he's connected to video production. This is where Scott would go through and he would set his hours. And then this is where you would connect with your calendar. So the available calendars that the system will synchronize with are Google Calendar, iCloud, Outlook, Live, Hotmail, Outlook Web App, Outlook Office 365, as well as an Exchange server, Yahoo. And if you have another kind of a calendar, you'll be able to connect with that as well. The next thing you're going to do, let me also point out, if you have Google Calendar as your primary calendar, make sure you make your account on the back office of the system using your Gmail account. That's going to make it a lot easier, and it also makes sure that your appointments come in faster. And you're going to go through, set your notifications. So it's exactly the same. We're going to go back to the main staff screen. From here, we would set our services. Now, for you guys, your services are going to be different depending on what kind of business you're in. The kinds of things you want to think about are going to be sales-related tasks, such as if you're a doctor and you have patients that want to, or new patients that are interested in having a quick call with you. Maybe it's to check and see if you take their insurance. Maybe it's to check and see if it's the right type of expertise. If you're accepting new patients, then you can allow somebody to do a new patient call. If you're an attorney, it can be a free consultation. If you are an HVAC company, it can be a service tech request, a maintenance request, an emergency request. You may also set it up by location. So this is your Dallas office, your New York office, your Chicago office, and your LA office. So we have a distributor that has a bunch of showrooms. And so they may have their Myrtle Beach showroom, their New York showroom, their New Jersey showroom, their South Carolina showroom, and so forth. So that's another way to do that. For the showrooms, the staff, they need to set consultations. As far as adding a new service, it's this simple. You click add a new service. You're going to say you want to show it on the menu, and do you want clients to be able to see this via your services menu, yes or no. You're going to give it a title, such as free consultation, and then below that you may say for new clients only. And then you're going to pick your phone or your appointment type. So either they call you, you call them. This is a tool, a conferencing tool that we have built into the back of the system. Also, you meet at their location, at your location, on Skype, other meetings. So for me, pretty much everything we do is online other meeting, and it is our GoToMeeting account. So once you drop this down, you would put in the information such as a URL, or if it's at your location, you would put in your office address, so you can make it really easy. The duration, you can set the time, how long the appointments usually take. So let's say they're calling in and all they're doing is actually setting a time with you to set the next appointment. Then this may be 15 minutes or 10 minutes. If they're calling in for a consultation or a presentation and so forth, then you can expand it. If this is something that's on site at their office, such as a new installation or something, and you're actually going to have it tied to a tech schedule, then you can say normally that's a 4-hour process or a 5-hour process, and you can block those off. You also can set preparation time, which means that you're not going to be booked back to back to back. So if you need 10 minutes in between meetings, then go ahead and set it. If you like your spare time, then you can move it up. All right, next, intervals. You can say appointments are calculated automatically, which that's the most optimized way. So for me, I want 10 minutes in between meetings and I want it to optimize it, which means I want the system to coordinate those 10-minute schedules. For the availability, you can set specific time frames you're going to be available for this service. So you may only do presentation calls or sales calls or consult calls or new client onboarding or client trainings on Mondays and Wednesdays. So for this particular service, you can say what the day and time is that you'll make yourself available. For example, I have speaking events that I do, and that is the only time that I'm going to make myself available on Saturdays and Sundays, and it's also the only time I'm going to make myself available after hours. So when the business is closed, I'm with family. However, after hours, if I have a speaking event and that's what they're booking, that's what this service is, then all of a sudden those hours are going to open up and they're going to be able to pick from those in case they have an evening event or they want a keynote for a cocktail party, something like that. All right, and same thing with your emergency requests. If you have emergency service requests, then you can open it up to a 24-hour schedule and so forth. Next, you can say, don't display a fee. You can say this is a fixed fee and you can request payment up front. This is a fixed fee, or the fee will be discussed with the client, or it's free, and pick either one. And then you can choose which staff member it's going to be set with. For us, we created these accounts based on departments. So this is strategy and growth planning. This is training, client services, video production, finance and accounting. And then you're just simply going to save that new service and it's going to show up in your services list. You can reorder your services based on priority. So for us, we actually gave them labels. So we'll say, go ahead and go book your appointment online and you're going to choose option number 2. Or you're going to choose option A or B and so forth. Then you can go through, same thing, calendar. You can set your time zones and so forth for scheduling options. You can ask for, there's lots of different things. So I can say, I want to accept meetings manually, meaning I get lots of requests. It doesn't mean I accept every meeting. So this is basically saying that somebody can choose up to 3 time slots when they are requesting versus, and they can request and I can either accept it, review it, reassign it, or reschedule it, or decline it. And this is also saying meetings should be scheduled at least how long in advance, and they can be scheduled at least how many months out from the current date. So you may not want somebody to be able to schedule 9 months from now because you might be in Tahiti having a martini. Terms of service, you can also put in your terms of service. Email clients, add or schedule with new clients without providing an email address. I want an email address. If I'm going to give my time, I want an email address. So, online scheduling, you can say I don't offer online scheduling, and it's going to turn this piece of the service off. So some of you may be using this strictly to allow customers to contact you and ask you questions online, more like a contact us page, and you don't want them to have anything to do with scheduling or your calendar, and that's fine as well. All right, emails and notifications. You can set up thank you messages, thank you for your appointment messages. You can also set reminders. I love this because somebody goes to our website, they schedule an appointment, I look at it, I accept it, and I know they're going to get a notification, and I'm going to get a notification, which I probably need more than them, 30 minutes before the appointment. It's going to send also a text message to both myself as well as the customer. It's going to give me a second message in 15 minutes, because Lord knows a lot can happen in 15 minutes, and I'll probably forget again. And same thing with invoices. It can send reminders of late payments, and when does the reminder go out? And you can also set up all of your email signature templates for tons of different things. So we'll go here. These are all the different kinds of notices that the system automatically will create for you. Everything from meetings accepted, canceled, expired, invited, you missed a note, you reschedule request, say that 10 times, a new time proposed, declined, reminders, you're requesting a cancellation, requesting notification, reminders, schedule invitations, and so forth. You also have additional business, so you may have dispatch schedules, dispatch canceled, expired notifications, and so forth. And same thing with tentative, if you're not quite sure yet. All right, we're going to go back to our settings, and we'll move into payments. Now, for payments, you have the ability to take payments online. These are one-time payments, so no reoccurring payments, but you can have your clients make a single payment to the account or to an invoice. So you can connect it either with your PayPal account. Ours is connected with our bank account, and you can say what the currency is. You can do email notifications for invoices and so forth. Very simple. You also have the ability to brand your primary site, which is more like your contact us page, and so forth. So let's go in and let's do a quick test drive to see. On here, we're going to be able to see account history, conversations. So the customer is going to be able to put their email address in here, submit. Let's see if I have one in here. Yeah. So I do, but it's going to send me a notice. I can check payments, documents, and so forth. All right, let's move back, and we're going to go head over to payments real quick. So for payments, you have the ability to create a new invoice. In the invoice, you can simply type in the company's name. So how about Brian Andrade with law firm, our Texas law firm? So I'll use him for a test. We'll go through, put in an invoice number, the date of issue, your due date, your currency, select the product or service. So I can say this is what the service is. It can be from the list, or you can change it and you can put your own in here like this. You can put in a description, the quantity. You can put in a price. If there's any tax or discount, you can add an item, and you can continue to add items in order to send out your invoice. You can also offer clients to pay online. It's going to send them an email, but you're going to give them the option to just pay directly on your website, which is really, really, really easy. The last thing you want to do is make it difficult for a client to pay you. That would be a bad day. Okay, so in a nutshell, you have your inbox. You have your calendar. You can show your calendar, schedule appointments, so people don't just have to schedule appointments with you. If you want to set an appointment with someone in your client base, then you would simply pick who that is, give it a topic, and say we need to go over the proposal, send a date, propose time, send it out. Why would I do this instead of sending an email? Because the system's going to remind them, put it on my calendar, put it on their calendar, track any changes, and track all of the activities. So when they come back to our site and they click on my account, they can see all that communication on your website. So I don't want to go to an email and just simply shoot it out. I want to do it from the system, because I want the system to take care of the operational functions that take up minutes when it comes to scheduling, booking, rescheduling, coordinating, reminding, and everything else related to meetings, which takes up way, way, way too much time for most business owners. And then you can add a description and say, hey, Warren, I just want to touch base with you regarding the proposal I sent you. I sent you a couple proposed times. Please let me know if this works. And you can request that the client confirms. The appointment will be scheduled only after the client accepts it. I'm going to hit schedule. Boom, it's gone. So that's simple. I can payments, we've got it. Payment summaries, create an invoice, payment settings, publish. So here's some cool tools. So one, we're going to add this to your website for you. So we're going to add a little widget on your site that pops up. You guys have seen this on the CI Web Group site right here in the bottom right hand corner. That's where this widget pops up, as well as on the sidebar. In addition to that, we'll fully integrate it with your site. You can also do cool things like contact forms, scheduling calendar, your sidebars. We can add it to the sidebars. You can also send a mobile invitation. So very smart. If I have somebody that says, well, I'm interested in booking an appointment with you, you happen to be on a computer, they're in their car, you say, no problem, what's your cell phone? Type it in, send a message, message sent. It's going to send them a quick message with a link that looks just like this. As soon as they hit the link, it's going to pop into their cell phone. They can either schedule an appointment right here from their phone, or they can leave details, contact information about what they're interested in. They can call you right here. They can make a payment directly from their phone, or they can upload a document. Maybe you need a picture for of their current air conditioning unit, or you need a picture of a room they want to redesign, or you need a picture of an agreement that you need they need you to review, and so forth. So then they can view activity, they log in, and they have access to all of the communications with you. So really quick way to be able to get your contact information to a client on their time and in the easiest fashion. Okay, live site buttons. You also have the ability to, you can send action links to clients. You can add links to your website. You can put them on the bottom of your website. You can add these to the bottom of your email signatures. So you should all have an email signature that has a link. So if I was going to go create a new message, it says click here to schedule a meeting. If they click this, it's going to take them right over to my scheduler. And then finally, you have a public profile. You also have statistics. You can see the engagement on your stats. So this is just installed, and in a matter of, 4 days, you're going to see there was 188 widgets that had been seen, 5 public profiles. So today there's 280. We had 54 people schedule appointments today. So it kind of gives you an idea. This is a great way to track conversions. Simple enough. This is a tool that can really, really help you guys maximize your business. And if you guys are interested in getting more information, or you'd like us to integrate this with your website, definitely go to ciwebgroup.com, click on the contact us schedule, and schedule an appointment. And you are going to pick the very first one that says a free consultation and strategy session with me. And we'll set up time to go over everything and make sure that you have all your questions answered. And it is just that simple. So in your business, calculate the number of minutes and hours and time that you are spending on scheduling appointment, and the missed opportunities from traffic and people coming to your website and not taking action right then. And when you calculate up the lost opportunity costs, as well as the operational expenses related to human capital that's being wasted, minutes and minutes and minutes, day over day over day, month over month, year over year, it's time to get automated. And this automation is going to make you free up time that you can spend on high leverage activities, such as building more a bigger client base, generating new business, or improving your operations or client retention things, things that actually make you money instead of administrative busy work. So with that, thanks so much. I appreciate your time. Hope this helps, and we'll talk to you soon.